This is Joe Bloom with another digital art podcast. Today I'll be working on an illustration. I'm working with a Wacom Intuos 3 4x5 tablet. It's a simple Graphire. I'm thinking about going to a Cintiq, but for now I would do this. As you can see, I'm doing an illustration of Wes Anderson's, some of his favorite actors that he chooses, some people that he repeats. It's for a magazine called Naked Eye Magazine. It's a Canadian pop culture magazine. It talks about entertainment and actors and things like that. You can see that I'm partially finished with Ben Stiller here. The look I'm going for is something like this one, where it's a sister illustration. It's Judd Apatow's favorite, or Apatow, I'm not sure how you say that. His favorite actors. You've got Steve Carell, Will Ferrell, you know, Seth Rogen, some of the writers, some of the people, Jonah Hill. A lot of the people that he likes to reuse and reuse in different movies, a lot of his comedians and friends. And it's a simple cartoon-style illustration. You can see if you zoom in, there's not a whole lot of detail. This is 100%. But I want to keep a cartoony feel with a little bit of realistic rendering going on. So I'm just going to minimize that, get out of the way. So here I've got the same thing. I'll add the white later. I start with a basic skin tone. I started in layers. What I did is I started with a skin tone just like this. And then I started sketching. For the first illustration, I was using pencil. But for this one, I decided I wanted to start sketching digitally, so I did this. I took out Ben Stiller's face in the process, but you'll see why in a second. I basically, in this layer, I just select a black, select a brush that I like, which has sort of a progressive fade to it, and use it straight up just like this. You can see just a general brush stroke. Now, when I use that brush, I basically can erase, go back and forth, and sketch out just a rough idea of where I want everyone. I can move things around, I can edit it, and I sketch that at full opacity, so it's, you know, kind of a harsh sketch. Now, when I'm ready to start coloring, I just drop the opacity a little bit. This is a linear burn. There are layer modes, as you can see here. There's normal, dissolve, dark, and multiply, different things that are additive to darks or additive to lights, I guess you could say. This one affects things in a dark manner. It linear burn and just basically sort of burns the color a little bit into it rather than a total gray value. So I can use a black and you'll get a little bit of the color base. So that from there I add some color underneath it. Just basic local colors, their clothes, their face, their skin tones, and a little bit of shadowing for some of them. So this is a basic idea of where I want to go with this. Ben Stiller's face is erased, of course, because I started painting him. And then on a separate layer on top, you can see I have my skin tone layer, my drawing layer. Underneath that, I have the basic local colors. And then on top of that, I'll make it visible here. You can see Ben Stiller. He appears. This is where I painted him. Now I've got into a little bit of detail. It's not a huge illustration, only be about 6 inches wide or so. And I have, this is at 100% right here, where you can see I've got Ben Stiller's face. It's still not finished, but it's getting close. I'm not getting too detailed. I want to keep it relatively cartoony. I like to render detailed illustrations and paintings, but for this one, I want to be able to get it done in a relatively quick time because I've got a busy schedule, and yet I want to keep a fun, cartoony, consistent feel. And when I'm making up fabric and hands and using different references, I can unify them with color and with an approach to a certain level of detail with my brush stroke. So that's what I'm dealing with right now. Now I've got a picture here that I grabbed from a DVD of Bill Murray. He's got this funny look to the side because the art director and editor, actually the editor of the magazine, wonderful woman, her name is Renee. She asks that I have them interacting as though they're just sort of in a group standing around like friends would do if they're a little occupied or if they're kind of distracted. One of them's moody, you know, another one's looking at another one, one looks happy. So I've got Bill Murray kind of looking confused and annoyed maybe at Angelica Houston because of the relationship their characters usually carry in movies. So I'm just going to set this aside here. That's my reference. Now I'm not picking colors for this. What I'm doing is I am starting with a basic palette. I might use color as a reference, like maybe his hat color. I'll grab that and use it as a basis for reference for color. But I established a skin tone palette that I want to be fairly consistent. Bill Murray has a similar skin tone to Ben Stiller. He's not much more pale than him, so I'm just going to start with a basic palette here that I'm using for Ben Stiller, which is this background color as a base. And I don't do this often, but I like to experiment when I'm painting. with digital stuff and with anything. I like to experiment and try things new because I want to expand my horizon. So this sketching and then painting all digitally is something I haven't really done that much before. I've done it once or twice, but I've never done it for a commission piece. So this is sort of new ground for me. And what I'm doing is I'm blocking in areas of light and dark. So I'm going to work on the top layer where Ben Stiller is. See, I can subtract him and put him back. On that layer, I'm going to paint as though I'm just painting with acrylics, just painting or gouache, just a complete one-shot process where I just add, subtract, and I'm going to take the lightest value, or the I would not say the lightest value, but the base value of his face, this area that has sort of this big consistent color without highlights, and I'm going to use that to paint along with the shadows where the average slightly darker value lies in his face. And from there I can add and subtract, push and pull, move things around, try to get the caricature where I want it. Not going too exaggerated this time. I know usually exaggeration is the name of the game, but so now I'm going to pull this shadow color off of Ben Stiller's forehead here. I think that's a good reference. I'm going to pull up my color swatches and I'm going to go a little bit lighter, maybe a little pinker. So now that is the basis of my shadow color. I'll just plop it right here so I have that for reference. Now I'm going to build in his eye area. This is just the starting point. I'm going to be adding, subtracting, playing with this. I want his eye pulling a little lower. He's got this droopy eye. I have a drawing on my website that's very similar to this one. So I've had a little bit of experience. It's not cheating, but it's about as close as you can get to it. Doing this almost this drawing before. Found it in a magazine and I liked his expression because his one eye, as you can see, looks a lot higher on this side. It's just really fun. So I'll be trying to play with little subtleties like that. Won't be going too exaggerated. So